What's going on, guys? It is your favorite monkey reporting for Gaming News Weekly Blitz, and we have two stories from EA or DICE about their two games coming to an end. Let's jump right into that. So if we head over to Twitter, we can see on the official page for Battlefield 5 on the 23rd of April, they have announced an update on the future of Battlefield 5. And interestingly enough, somebody asked, is this confirming Chapter 7 will be the last major update or chapter in this game? And they replied with, there will be no new chapter after the... Wait. There will be no new chapter. There should be a comma. But there will be a standalone update this summer with new content, weapons, and game tweaks. Which is interesting that it is a telltale sign that after Chapter 6, the game will end its live services. Let us scroll down. So after scrolling down and laughing at some of the memes, we get to this point, after which the game will essentially end content wise, or will there be further content during the winter? Where Battlefield replied, we're continuing with new weekly missions and rewards, and our update this summer will deliver new content to support that. We otherwise have no further content planned beyond our updates to community games and ensuring healthy game performance. And this is very interesting that there will be no more content after Chapter 6. And I was scouring the internet looking for something that could be an official explanation, where I have landed on their official page. So I will leave a link down below in the description for this article of Battlefield 5, where it says the future of Battlefield 5, an update with Ryan MacArthur, which is the senior producer, and he details the Tides of War changes, community games, and more coming after Chapter 6. Let's go ahead and read over here. What's coming after Battlefield 5 Chapter 6? As you're aware, the current Battlefield 5 chapter, Into the Jungle, wraps up on April 29th. As we look to the future, we will release one more standalone update this summer that brings with it some new content, weapons, and game tweaks. We are targeting June for this update. We're still tackling the challenges working from home, and we'll let you know how things progress for us over the next month, which is all fine and well. And if we go ahead and look on what's coming, it's just basically the new update for summer, weekly rewards, events and activities, and community games updates, plus continued work with anti-cheat. So there is no more explanation or whatnot, but rumor around the net, it is they are ending with chapter six, because of not reaching their target sales, having a very rocky start, and the pathetic attempt for a battle royale known as Firestorm they've tried to add. For myself, I do enjoy the Battlefield series, and I was never a fan of the Firestorm battle royale mode. But let us move on. Let's put a pin in here and move on to the next story. And this brings us to Star Wars Battlefront 2. After 2 years of free content, the vision for Star Wars Battlefront 2 is now complete, with creative director Dennis Brownville on a game's incredible journey through 25 free content updates, the battle on Scarif, and what's next. So if we go ahead and read over here, today we're bringing you details on what's coming for Star Wars Battlefront 2 in the next content update named Battle on Scarif, where we return to a tropical battlefront inspired by the Rogue One Star Wars story. And further down, we see, looking beyond April, we're transitioning to a phase where the servers, in-game challenges, recurring events such as double XP and more, and game support will carry this broad and rich Star Wars gaming experience into the future. This means that we're moving away from delivering regular content updates. As the game lives on with the players and our community, we're looking forward to hearing your stories for years to come. So basically, this means that content also will stop for Battlefront 2. Same as with Battlefield 5, Chapter 6, the content will stop. Unlike Battlefield 5, these servers or the services, live services, will still continue on, such as recurring events, double XP, in-game challenges, all those beautiful things for Battlefront. And we know that Star Wars Battlefront was basically the starting point for the whole saga surrounding loot boxes or gambling. So it also got off to a very rocky start, but it turned out to be a more well-rounded shaped game than what Battlefield 5 was, where Battlefield 5 tried to save itself by adding Firestorm Battle Royale mode, which also failed miserably. So this begs the question of what is coming. Well, apparently rumors on the internet, and for the life of me I cannot find that article, but somewhere around 2021 in November there will be another Battlefield coming out, and I think I have a small hunch, I think, that people from Battlefront 2 and Battlefield will collaborate and bring us a better game. And EA, if you're watching this video, make sure that you focus, if you're going to have a multiplayer focused game, focus on the multiplayer instead of the campaign, or just show us footage of that. You know, don't do what you did with Battlefield 5. But that's just my take on it, just my opinion. I will link both stories of these, both blog posts, into the description down below if you want to read about this a bit further on your own time. And I will also leave a link to my channel, Baboon King, where I play Last Day on Earth and those kind of things, if you want to join in there and share your opinion surrounding these stories with us in the comment section down below. And I will see you guys next time. Bye bye.